Assalamu alaikum students and welcome to our channel. Today we are going to solve some problems of arithmetic sequence. You have learned basic concept of arithmetic sequence in our previous lecture. So let's start with first question of exercise 6.2. Write first four terms of arithmetic sequence if its fifth term is 17 and its ninth term is 37. As you know that to find the general term of an arithmetic sequence, we use formula an equals to a1 plus n minus 1 into d. Here d is the common difference between two consecutive terms of the arithmetic sequence. N is the number of term and a1 is the first term of this sequence. So we can write a5 as a1 plus 5 minus 1 into d equals to 17, or a1 plus 4d equals to 17. This is our equation number 1. Also we can write a9 as a1 plus 9 minus 1 into d, which is equals to 37. a1 plus 8d equals to 37. This is our equation number 2. Subtracting equation 2 from 1 or 1 from 2. a1 plus 8d equals to 37 and a1 plus 4d equals to 17. On solving these two equations, we will get the answers of d and a1. Here 4d equals to 20 and d is equals to 5, which is the common difference. To find the value of a1, replacing the value of d in equation 1 or 2 by putting value of d in equation number 1, a1 plus 4d, which is equals to 5, equals to 17. a1 plus 20 equals to 17. a1 equals to 17 minus 20 and a1 equals to minus 3. Now we have our first term of the sequence and the common difference of the sequence. We can find all other terms of this sequence. A2 is equals to A1 plus D. First term plus common difference. So A1 is minus 3 and D is 5. A2 will become equals to 2. A3 is equals to A1 plus 2 times difference, or you can write A2 plus D. Here a1 is minus 3 plus 2 times 5 minus 3 plus 10 equals to 7. Also a4 is equals to a1 plus 3 time difference. a1 is minus 3 plus 3 time d is 5 minus 3 plus 15 equals to 12. So first four terms of this sequence are minus 3, 2, 7 and 12. By this question, you have learned that if you know the two terms of any sequence, arithmetic sequence, you can find any other term of this sequence. Let's move to another question. Question number 7 is, which term of the arithmetic progression minus 2, 4, 10 and so on is 148? As minus 2, 4, 10 is in an arithmetic progression, we have a1 equals to minus 2 first term, the common difference between two consecutive terms, 4 minus minus 2 or 10 minus 4. 4 minus minus 2, which is equals to 6. We have to find the value of n. We have a n, which is equals to 148. By using general term formula, a n equals to a 1 plus n minus 1 into d. A n equals to a 1 plus n minus 1 into d. Here a n is equals to 148. A 1 is minus 2 plus n minus 1. D is equals to 6. Moving minus 2 to left hand side, 148 plus 2 equals to n minus 1 into 6. 150 equals to n minus 1 into 6, dividing both sides by 6. 150 divided by 6 equals to n minus 1 into 6 divided by 6. This becomes n minus 1 equals to 25, or n equals to 25 plus 1, n equals to 6, 26. So 148 is the 26th term of this sequence. Let's move to another question. If L, M, N are the pth, qth and rth term of an arithmetic progression, show that L into Q minus R plus M into R minus P and N into P minus Q equals to 0. As mentioned in the question that L is the pth term of this sequence, M is the qth term and N is the rth term. By using general term formula, we can write L equals to A1 plus P minus 1 into D, as L is the pth term of this sequence. This is our equation number 1. L equals to A1 plus D P minus D. Also, we can write M equals to A1 plus Q minus 1 into D, or M equals to A1 plus Q D minus D. This is our equation number 2. And N equals to A1 plus R minus 1 into D, or N equals to A1 plus R D minus D. This is our equation number 3. Now replacing the values of L, M and N in left hand side of our question. Left hand side is L into Q minus R plus M into R minus P plus N into P minus Q. Here L is equals to A1 plus DP minus D into Q minus R plus M is equals to A1 plus QD minus D into R minus P, and N is equals to A1 plus RD minus D into P minus Q. On multiplying, we will get A1 Q minus A1 R plus D P Q minus D P R minus D Q plus D R. Also A1 R minus A1 P plus R Q D minus P Q D minus D R plus dp and a1p minus a1q plus prd minus qrd minus dp plus dq. You will see that the two terms are same with different signs. We can cancel this term a1q minus a1q minus a1r plus a1r dpq minus dpq minus dpr plus dpr minus dq plus dq plus dr minus dr minus a1p plus a1p and rqd minus rqd and dp minus dp. We will get answer 0, which is our right hand side. So we have proved that L into Q minus R plus M into R minus P plus N into P minus Q is equals to 0. Let's move to another topic, which is arithmetic mean. To find the arithmetic mean between two numbers, you have learned a formula: arithmetic mean is equals to A plus B by 2. The arithmetic mean between two values A and B. Here we have to find the arithmetic means between three arithmetic means between 3 and 11. Let A1, A2 and A3 are three arithmetic means between 3 and 11. We represent arithmetic means by capital A. So 3, A1, A2, A3 and 11 are in arithmetic progression, by definition of arithmetic progression. Here we have now 5 terms: 3, A1, A2, A3 and 11. Our first term is small a1, which is 3. Our fifth term is A5 equals to 11, as 11th is on 5th position. We can write A5 as A1 plus 5 minus 1 into D or 4D, which is equals to 11. Replacing value of A1, which is 3, 3 plus 4D equals to 11, or 4D equals to 11 minus 3, 4D equals to 8, or D equals to 2. On finding common difference, we can find all other terms as we have our first term. So first arithmetic mean A1 is equals to, A1 is on second position, which is small a2, A2 which is equals to A1 plus D. Here A1 is 3 and the common difference is 2, so this will become 5. Also A2 is on third position, A3 is equals to A1 plus 2D. A1 is 3 plus 2 into common difference is 2, 3 plus 4 equals to 7, and capital A3 equals to small a4, which is equals to A1 plus 3D. A1 is 3 plus 3 into the common difference is 2, 3 plus 6 equals to 9. Three arithmetic means between 3 and 11 are 5, 7 and 9. Let's move to the last question of our today's topic. Find n so that a raised to power n plus b raised to power n over a raised to power n minus 1 plus b raised to power n minus 1 may be the arithmetic mean between a and b. As you know that the arithmetic mean between a and b is equals to a plus b divided by 2. If a raised to power n plus b raised to power n over a raised to power n minus 1 plus b raised to power n minus 1 is an arithmetic mean between a and b, we can write a raised to power n plus b raised to power n over a raised to power n minus 1 plus b raised to power n minus 1 equals to a plus b divided by 2. On cross multiplication, we will get 2 into a raised to power n plus b raised to power n equals to a plus b a raised to power n minus 1 plus b raised to power n minus 1. On multiplying 2 a raised to power n plus 2 b raised to power n equals to a into a raised to power n minus 1 plus a into b raised to power n minus 1 plus a raised to power n minus 1 into b plus b into b raised to power n minus 1. This will become 2 a raised to power n plus 2 b raised to power n equals to a raised to power n. As bases are same, powers will be added, plus a b raised to power n minus 1 plus a raised to power n minus 1 into b plus b raised to power n. Now we will shift a raised to power n and b raised to power n to left hand side. 2 a raised to power n minus a raised to power n plus 2 b raised to power n minus b raised to power n is equals to a b raised to power n minus 1 plus a raised to power n minus 1 into b. It will become a raised to power n plus b raised to power n equals to a into b raised to power n minus 1 plus a raised to power n minus 1 into b. Now shifting a raised to power n minus 1 to left hand side and b raised to power n to right hand side, it will become a raised to power n minus a raised to power n minus 1 into b equal to a into b raised to power n minus 1 minus b raised to power n. Now we can take b a raised to power n minus 1 common from left hand side and b raised to power n minus 1 from right hand side. On taking common a raised to power n minus 1, here we have a raised to power n, so the remaining value will be a minus a raised to power n minus 1. On taking common, it will become b. Here b raised to power n minus 1 will be taken, we will get a minus b. We can cancel a minus b by a minus b, dividing both sides by b raised to power n minus 1. We will get a raised to power n minus 1 over b raised to power n minus 1 equals to 1. We can write a over b whole raised to power n minus 1 equals to a over b whole power 0. As you know that any value raised to power 0 is equals to 1. To make the basis same, we have write a over b to the power 0 instead of 1. So we can write n minus 1 equals to 0 and our n is equals to 1. That's all about today's lecture. Stay blessed. Thank you.